Monday morning to you. This is Coach Lou coming to you with a little bit of Monday motivation. There's a lot of hoopla about this Monday motivation. Monday has a lot of mixed emotions attached to it in this world. Some people wake up and go, oh my God, it's Monday. Oh, I got to get up. Oh, I got to face this week. Other people get up and go, hey, bam, let's kick butt this week. Let's get it going. Let's get it on and go. It's going to be a great week. It's going to be amazing. Let's get rolling here. Some people get up at 4:30, 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock in the morning. Some people get up at 9 o'clock in the morning after hitting the snooze button 3 or 4 or 5 times. Well, being a sleep sciences coach, that snooze button and I have a real dislike for each other with what I've learned over the years in my personal experience, but also what I've learned in my education as a sleep sciences coach as well. The snooze button can be really hazardous to your health and your overall productivity. What am I talking about? Well, perfect day to talk about it. It's Monday. It's our Monday motivation segment. So guys, let's talk about this. We have sleep cycles that we go through. You go in that initial phase of light sleep. You go into phase 2, 3, which is your deep formless sleep. And then you go into your REM sleep. And I'm not going to get overly detailed on this today, but your REM sleep is where you do your dreaming. So that'll give you an idea. So you go through this cycle about every 90 minutes. What happens is when you go through these cycles, if you wake up preferably at the end of that fourth cycle, that's when you wake up naturally and go, I'm refreshed and ready to go for the day. If you come out of that deep sleep, that's when you come out groggy. In that initial sleep, you can go in and out of and you feel funny. That's why napping is a whole animal to itself, so you can't really just lay down for 20 minutes. But I'll talk more about the napping concept on a different segment. So for Monday motivation today, let's talk about that snooze button. You reach up and go, bam, 8, 10, 12 minutes. You just get back into that level 1 or level 2 sleep and you're and woken right back up out of it. Definitely not the way to start the day. Your body, your hormones, everything is thrown off. So what I'm going to do here is ask you for a quick challenge for the next 10 days. I'd say 7 days, but we want to make it past the next Monday. Let's do this. If I can get you to do a 10-day challenge with me, and I'd love comments, whether you're watching this video on YouTube, our blog, Facebook, I'd love to see some comments on your feeling. 10 days, guarantee that you will get up when the alarm goes off. Try to get an optimal time for your sleep to where you wake up and go, I feel pretty refreshed. If you could actually wake up before the alarm and you could adjust your bedtime, do that, just saying, to where you wake up 10 or 15 minutes before you would normally have that alarm go off and you wake up naturally out of that stage 4 you sleep, you're going to feel phenomenal through the day. But let's do this for 10 days. Again, I want you to commit to the first time the alarm goes off, no matter how you feel, get up and get your day started. No snooze button. Now, I'm not asking you for a lifelong commitment to this unless you feel really great doing it. Now, if you feel really great doing it, feel free to adapt this little life policy that we have here of no snooze button. But do this for 10 days for me. Love to get your feedback and your comments on this to see the difference if you get up without hitting snooze. I guarantee you Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, you will find a difference in your energy, your clarity, just by this little distinction. So share with me your comments, your ideas, and your experiences with this. I am really excited to be rounding the bend here into 2018. We have some exciting things coming up. My commitment to you is to deliver more quality information, more quality content through the blog, through the web, and to just really help be your coach. With your permission, I'd love to be your coach throughout the year. At Revitalize Life, we'd love to be your fitness coaches as well. We do fitness and life coaching, so if you're local here in Orlando, we can do it locally. If you're not in the area, we can coach you remotely. But anyhow, again, ready to rock and roll into 2018. Do this 10-day challenge with me and let me know how this works. This is kind of an experiment also to see if it works as well outside of the community of our current clients that we coach on sleep and so forth. But I would love to see your energy level pick up on a Monday, and I would much rather see, yes, let's go get our week started on Monday, than, oh my God, why is that clock going off so early? Which do you think feels better? Which do you think you're going to serve your family, your loved ones, your business associates, your employers, the people that depend on you better? What state of mind are you going to come out of better? So if you have questions, feel free to email me. Click through to the website. Check it out. Love to connect with you. Until we meet in person or meet again, live with love, energy, passion. Always live your dream and be blessed. Coach Lou, Revitalize Life Fitness and Life Coaching, wishing you an awesome day.